Good evening everyone, this is Arvindpreet Kaur from HMB College Jalandhar. Today I'll be presenting a video abstract on the title Comparative Proteomic Analysis of Pseudomonas Pseudoalkyl Genes Protein Organophosphorus Hydrolysis 2 OPHC2 in Mesophilic, Cytrophilic and Halophilic Bacteria. Over the last 7 decades we have been using pesticides for the better crop production, and over 47% of these pesticides contain phosphoric acid, which are very much toxic to human beings as it stops the neurotransmission in the body, and over 200,000 deaths are reported annually due to organophosphate poisoning. So we need to remove them from the environment. Earlier we used to adopt physicochemical based remedial technologies which were very costly, time consuming and causes secondary pollution in the environment. So we need to develop bioremedial technologies, and with the advancement of biotechnology and recombinant DNA technology, which we can do it in a much better way. And we found a very promising candidate, OPHC2, that is organophosphorus hydrolase 2, in a mesophilic bacteria, Pseudomonas pseudoalkyl genes. So we need to know its structure in order to know its functions and apply it for bioremediation. So we did a small project to know its amino acid composition, which will pave a way to find its structure. So we took the faster sequence of organophosphorus hydrolase 2 in Pseudomonas pseudoalkyl genes and found its homologous sequences using BLAST-P, and we made a list of different mesophilic, cytrophilic and halophilic bacteria using BACDIVE database. And after that, we used expressive ProtParam tool in order to know the amino acid composition of different mesophilic, cytrophilic and halophilic bacteria. And we took the average and standard deviations of mesophilic, cytrophilic and halophilic bacteria. And then we draw a graph in order to get the deviation and the amino acid composition and compare mesophilic with cytrophilic and mesophilic with halophilic bacteria. This would help to make a genetically modified bacteria for the extreme environments, because mesophiles, like, we need to develop such bacteria from the extreme environmental conditions. So we need to know its amino acid composition, and after that we can know its structure in a much better way, with which we can develop a genetically modified bacteria and apply it for bioremediation. Thank you so much.